Hello and welcome to Farming Simulator 2017 with me, Kevin Sawyer. Hope you guys are well and enjoying your day, whatever you're up to. And as you can see, I'm finally got back onto Norfolkshire, to the classic farming series. So this is the map we're going to be doing it on. It's a combination of people voting, what was late gamers, and what I was more happy with. Again, you know, for you guys that didn't want to see more of this map and want to see more of the other maps, I'm sorry, I apologise in advance, but I quite enjoy this map. I quite like it a lot, and I think, you know, I think if I enjoy the map a bit more, it's going to be, you know, better, easier gameplay as well, purely because if it's a map I really hate, or I didn't hate Hagenstaden, I didn't hate the other map either, I just, out of the three, I think this is probably the one more newer map that's not being done a lot. Well, there isn't, some other were doing on YouTube are doing it, but not many. You know, there's a lot of newer maps out that a lot of people are covering at the moment as well, but I figured I might as well get on and make a start of it. So I'm starting off where I left off, really, from when we last live streamed this, which was collecting some hay, or straw, should say. So that's pretty much what's going to be today with the field work, pretty much. Be a bit rinse and repeat for you guys, and I apologise in advance, but them's are the breaks when you need to do it. I could have. Problem is, because I don't know the size of what this combine cut this at, and I don't have a windrow yet. It's a bit difficult to sort of like get a course play to do this work all for you. It's a tough that I left down. I hope you guys all well, and if you don't watch both my firm bus or my American trucks in here, you may notice we've got some new tunes now. For you guys that have watched them all, I'm sorry, you're going to sound like a broken record now, but I've put some tunes into the extra tunes into the library just to liven things up for you guys. Hope you guys enjoy them. Some of them are going to be way out there, some of them are going to be quite good, some will be quite catchy. Alright, almost full on this one. What I might do is get one of the workers to just start up on the side of the field in a minute. Once I've gone about halfway, get a worker to start mixing up some. How are we doing? We've got about 40 odd grand in the account, so I haven't done much work on this map at all since the last live stream. This I've been leaving it deliberately just to. I've been doing so much work on the other map, on Goldcrest. Kind of neglected this one altogether. Where did I leave my? So we've got to find out where I left my multi storage shed. No problem leaving my shed there. There's an actual fuel point just behind there, just in there, but that's not a biggie. I could put a fuel point anywhere else on the farm. Rock and roll. So quickly check the other fields and see what other fields need doing. So quick hop about. See, I think this field's done. Yeah, this field is done. Better bring that combine in. That's what we can get the wrong key. workers doing? They are tough, so I know, but they might let me go. It's not worth my time popping around to pick them up. This is, in a sense, free corn anyway, or free grain. Go and park this bad boy up. Gotta remind myself where I put everything. I think the combines are parked in here. Mirror's working here, but it's looking at it. Can't see a mirror. It's a blank spot. It's a shame. V, bring it down. No, I don't want to start it up. I need to lower my header. Jump out. Detach the PTO if this has got one. Yeah. And back it up. Without no mirror, it's a bit difficult to back this thing up. Before this thing had a mirror on it, but obviously it don't. There you go, that'll do. That'll do, donkey, that'll do. Maybe got smashed out, maybe that's the case of it. And also for you guys that don't watch ATS, I've got some good news. It kind of also works well with, it's going to work with Farming Simulator 2017, but I've ordered the parts from my button box. Yes, you heard me right. I've ordered the parts for my button box. Let me see. Where do I need to go? Yeah, this tractor needs to go back to the main farm. Take course play off. Need to park the trailer somewhere as well. Is that a fertilizer tower barrels or fuel tower barrels? Dunno. They look like some sort of, they look like fuel barrels to me. Should we pop out and find out? That looks like fuel tower barrels. Did a trigger come up to fill? We drive near it. No, maybe it's a fertilizer. Your guess is as good as mine, guys. In fact, we can. Oh, that's the old dirt. Yeah, empty, says me. There wasn't much in there, but every little helps, eh? Ah, yes, he's improved the hay trigger as well, because this may not be the current version, but I've updated it to, I forget what version I did update it to a couple of weeks back. And this actually says day one on the mod. This is how I haven't got the seasons mod in. I've just got the real-time mod, just to, for now, I might bring it in after I've done a year or so on this, or got to a point where this farm's sustainable, where I can manage the winter and everything else, the costs associated with it. Let's grab that dirt, park this here quickly. don't know if this thing has a light on it or not. I don't think it does. No, it doesn't. It's a shame. I might swap this out for the modded version of the dirt. So I think that's got lights in it. Right, where did I leave? And have we got one? There's a fertilizer. Let's quickly have a quick recap on what we've got in the garage. Don't think we've got... I have got more. That's a water bowser. Okay, I haven't actually got... Well, I haven't got any pigs or nothing yet anyway, so that's something else we need to worry about. Keep hitting the wrong keys today. Wrong key city. It's back there, isn't it? Beep, beep, beep. Yeah, so, yeah, going back to the button box. Yeah, I'm going to have several different... buttons on that, including an ignition switch, which will work on this. Alright. And buttons again, so I can configure the buttons however I like, so I can configure them to make things a bit easier for lowering and higher ploughs rather than having to use my wheel. I can just use a switch. Should be quite interesting. I send this out to this field over here, isn't it? It's going to need some fertiliser. Where do we top up fertiliser now? Do we need a fertiliser? Maybe this is a fertiliser. See what happens when I get near it. See if what triggers come up. Any camera at all. It could be a milk truck thing, I don't know. I'm looking on the map, what it's telling me, it's not really telling me much. Let's bring the map up larger. It doesn't tell me anything. So I'm wondering if we're going to have to buy one. Is there one on this farm already? Let's have a look around quickly. Like, yeah, you should have went around and oh, what's this? Is this one over here? This looks promising. Can we throw those bags in? Looks like it. No, just generic bags. To cost a fortune on its own, filling this thing up. Well, that's good to go. Jump back in cab. Let's close that box as well before the fertilizer falls out. To close, yeah. Got it on times 5 as well, which doesn't help, so let's slow time down. Must have hit that accidentally. I think we own that farm land over there as well, if I remember right. So I'll do that one next after this one. We'll make a start on this one and we'll get... There we go, mate. No. It's not the way I wanted to go. This could be another problem as well. Of course, the hard workers don't recognise it, mate. This field. I might have to get course play to do it. There we go. Got there in the end. Let's grab Where's another spare tractor there? This one at work. I don't think I've got anything else here, have I? That's combine. Now I've got to go and find my... the plough, where have I left that? So everyone's laughing, like, yeah. Yeah, you definitely needed to sort of familiarise yourself where it was again. It's like walking back onto a farm that you haven't been on for years. And it's like, where is everything? Or coming onto a multiplayer server. Because you don't know where everything goes. It's like, yeah. Just look round for everything. I'm sure I had one because I've seen it earlier. Where have I left it? The map would tell me. Gives you guys a good look around anyway. Good look around the farm, mind the trees. Not in there. I know it's in a shed somewhere. Whereabouts? There's a chicken coop. Oh, is it over here? Have we been here already? Let's look over here quickly. This feels vaguely familiar. Is that it over there? No, that's it over there, that'll do. It's right where in front of us, I think. It's like, Kev, yeah, it's right in front of you. Line it up roughly. Doesn't have PTO, does it? Numpty. This has beacon lights and a beacon view. Turn off that one as well, because we don't need that now. Right. Hire him off. Hopefully he'd do it as I want him to do it. There it goes. Or she, I should say. It's obviously she as well. She's off on the way. Tractor wheels are bouncing up right royally on that bit, I think. Right, I'll start go back to this guy's going well. Go back to what I was doing, which was doing hay or straw work, I should say. Not straw. These guys got eggs. There is a couple of eggs in there, but I'll wait for it while I'm coming up. Gotta move this trailer as well. Left dump, abandon that there. I've got to move it back to the main farm, the header back onto it. What's the start on this row? I think I may have started about halfway down that field on the other road. I'm starting this round and work my way back, push comes to shove. Do a couple more passes and then I'll leave it at that for an episode. Again, it's been a bit of rinse and repeat, but that is the nature of the beast when you're playing this game and starting up a new map and everything else. Well, a fairly new map. It's just going through the saga of having to sort of like do the straw collecting, etc. I could have set this to spread, but I want to get as much straw as I can for the cows, because I want to get them up and running as soon as we can, so we can get some more money in for more better stuff or better toys. One thing I've noticed, I've got to get, you may have already said this already, but my spinner for my wheel is getting a bit squeaky, so I've got to get some more oil and. So if I can drop some oil in that shaft, in the where the bearing is or wherever it's rubbing against the shaft, let's see if I can do that. If not, I'll just use some WD-40 and squirt it back in there. This lasted a while, it did free it up quite nicely. It only squeaks every now and again if I spin it really quick. But again, I want to say a big thanks to everyone that's been supporting me from day one. And a big hello to all the new subscribers that are coming in. The channel's now at 200. I keep saying 200. I've got to figure 200 in my head. 300. 330 subscribers now. Big thank you to all again for your support. Marching very quickly towards the 1,000 subscriber goal and going with the button box, like I said in American Truck Simulator. I won't go into the exact same details what I said, but I may have some spare buttons left over now, depending on how many spare buttons I've got left over, and we're going to have quite a few, and costs and everything. I may either sort of keep a few for spares, but I might grab a few, and then again, once I've got a bit more money again, is buy another encoder and a box, and then make another one as a giveaway. Might not be to the same detail as my one is, but the same amount of switches and all that, but once I do my button box, there's something which you guys, if you want to see how I did it, don't worry, I will be showing that. It'll be, I don't know, I think I'm probably going to try and get it done as one video. I'll just edit it down for bits and pieces, and bits that where it just drops off or whatever. But I'll try and make it as informative as I can, but it'll be a tutorial on how to build a button box for yourselves, guys. Whoops, I hit the trailer. It's like, Ledford strikes again, right? Yeah. But the most expensive part of the build... Ooh, really? Cut that bit too fine. Stop. Does the actual gauge work? Doesn't look like it's moving. I'm trying to figure out what it actually is. It doesn't move, but it's a bit, just sits. Looks like a compressed air module. I wonder what that sign says. Okay. Never noticed that before. Is that part of the... Is that part of the... That we've got the forks on here? Possibly. Don't see the other controls on here either. Rabbit and hares! That's cool. Rabbit and turtle settings. Alright guys, I think I'll leave it at that. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. Again guys, feel free to like if you did. If you know anyone else that may also enjoy watching the episode, again guys, feel free to share. It helps me out a lot and I don't mind at all. And if you're new to my channel and want to see future episodes of this, or anything else that I'm working on, please don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in the next one. TTFM.